Now if we look at the verbal structure of Quran, there is a verb, there is a subject and there is an object. Same as English language, verb jo kaam ho raha hota hai, subject jo kaam karne wala hota hai, the doer, and object jis pe kaam ho raha hota hai. Let's take this example from Quran. Khalaqallahu Adama. Now if you see a word in Quran with three zabars consecutively, teen zabar aap Quran mein kisi bhi lafz ke upar dekhein, that would be a past tense, that would be a verb. Khalaqa, usne create kiya. Kataba, usne likha. Jalasa, wo baitha. Zahaba, wo gaya. Isi tarah kasara, usne toda. To Allah Ta'ala keh raha hai khalaqallahu, ye verb ho gaya aapka past tense. Jiske upar pesh aati hai, that always becomes subject in the verbal sentence. Yani Allah ne paida kiya, aur jiske saath kaam hua hota hai, jis pe hua tha, usko bolte hai object. Aur object always comes with zabar. To in verbal structure ko samajhna bada aasan hai. Verb recognize karna hai aapne, uske baad subject ke upar hamesha pesh hoga aur object ke upar hamesha zabar hoga. So if you want to solve the structures and sentences of Arabic language like these, you can do it very nicely and swiftly with joining the course Applicative Quranic Arabic. Yeah.